Hello and welcome to my channel. About 4 weeks ago, I did a video on 7 reasons why you should not quit. And I was giving an analogy that you can go on break, but don't quit. I didn't know I was going to go on break for 4 weeks. Well, I knew what was coming, but I didn't think I was going to go on break for 3 to 4 weeks. I gave birth to twins, yes. For the past 9 months, yeah. I was heavy even though I was doing your video. So I'm sure a lot of you that have been watching my video wondering, why is she so big? Why is she so huge? You know, those who have asked me, love, why are you so fat? Is it because you're making so much money? Is it because you're making dollars? But now you know, I was huge because I was pregnant and God has delivered me of twins, a boy and a girl. Don't worry, just like I show my first daughter in some of my videos, don't worry, soon I'll be showing you the twins in some of the videos as well. Okay, so today we're going to look at living a life of purpose and empowerment. When God created each and every one of us, He created us for a purpose. Some of us discovered our purpose when we're very young, and some do not discover the purpose until when they are old. It's fine. Anytime you discover your purpose, if you're living a life now and you're not feeling fulfilled, you're not feeling accomplished, why not go within and ask God? You can ask that question. Why am I living this life that I'm so unfulfilled? I was telling some group of people the other day, this life is short. You don't know whether you're going to live at 50 or 60. So you want to live it fulfilled, such that when God says it's time to go, you will tell Him, Lord, I'm ready because I came, I saw, and I conquered. So you've lived a life of fulfillment. So you need to actually go within and ask God, what is my purpose for this life? For me, I think your purpose is knitted with your talent. Once you have discovered your talent and you're able to develop it and use it to serve life, you will find out that you'll be living a much more fulfilling life. As a person, I didn't discover my talent on time. When I was young, I had a younger brother. My younger brother, we discovered his talent on time because he was a born artist. When my friends come to visit me before you leave my house, my brother would have sketched your picture looking exactly like you. And he was young, he was in primary school. I was in primary school as well. Because at that time, I didn't know the value of talent. I didn't know anything about talent anyway. I felt he was doing a wrong thing. Let me not deceive you. I felt he was embarrassing me. So I'll go and report him to my father that my friend came and my brother sketched, you know, that picture and he has given to them. So for me, I didn't realize that anything. I didn't know anything about talent. So my father too didn't know, he was ignorant. So he would beat the living daylight out of him until my brother lost interest in drawing, because my mother was like, why do you want to keep drawing? Who are you going to turn out to be? You're going to be irresponsible. It's only irresponsible people that are artists. I want you to read, I want you to be a doctor or be, you know, a lawyer. So that was the issue. But years later, I discovered my talent, but it was a journey for me. So I'm going to tell you the little story. There's a video we're working on now, because like I told you guys, we're working on a project, a company that we're about to launch. So there's some videos that we are working on to put on our website, and a particular video will give you this story. Yeah, a young girl was voicing it because it was actually supposed to be when I was young. So, but now I'm here to tell you the story, even in the voicing. She wouldn't tell you where exactly what happened. She will just tell you a story, it's about my story, so you want to tell you exactly what happened. Like, I'm here now because it's my story, it's my true life story, so I'll be able to tell you what happened, where and how. Now, my journey into discovering my talent, when I was young in primary school, my father and my mother, so my parents, told me that handwork, using your hand to do an handwork, is very important. And for you to succeed in life, you must know at least one handwork. So that stuck in my brain. When I got to secondary school, I said I wanted to do science, so I was in science class, and we're doing clothing and textile. We're supposed to sew pillow. When I sewed my pillow, it was the worst in the class. It wasn't fine at all. My friends laughed at me very well. But then I submitted my pillow. So when I finished secondary school, before I got admission, I went to fashion designing school. Remember, my parents told me I have to do one handwork. So I went to a fashion design school to learn, you know, fashion, to learn tailoring, isn't it? And I learned for 2 years. I could not sew a skirt. I could not sew a skirt. I could remember my fellow apprentice now, her name is Basirat. She was always laughing at me, making jest of me, because the only thing I could do for 2 years was hemming of a skirt, using the needle to hem the skirt. And I got out when we did the clothing and textile, because in our clothing and textile too, it was hemming or something out. Even my hemming was ugly. Okay, so when I left fashion, I went to school. When I discovered I wasn't meant for science, I just didn't want to do science again, so I changed to commercial. I went to study business administration in the institution. I came to Abuja, and when I was in Abuja, at the time I felt, oh, I still had handwork. I was doing my business actually, then I still remember handwork. So I went to catering school in Women Development Center in Abuja, a popular place, and I went for my catering, and I was a classwork. However, when we're doing the cake, we're doing our exam, I designed the cake. My cake, well, actually, okay, I think the part of the exam that we all of us should design our cake, my cake was the ugliest. I got laughed at very well as well. So in my frustration, one day I went for a program, and you know, they're talking about a talent development consultant, and it was actually about you discovering yourself. So I waited with a woman, and she told me about talent. That was when she told me so much about talent. And I like, okay, talent. So we started talking about the essence of life, why you need to discover your talent, if you're doing something you love, your passion. So I started talking, okay, but my parents said I should learn handwork. I said, handwork, but let's see, what exactly do you love doing? What is that thing you can do for free? So I said, what can I do for free? I said, I like to talk, so I can talk for free. I love to talk, that's what I love to do. So she said, okay, talking, let's see. Those who love to talk, what are the things you can do? So she told me, would you like to be a lawyer? I said, lawyer? No, I don't want to be a lawyer. Said, talking, would you like to be a comedian? I said, I can't even make myself laugh. I cannot be a comedian. Would you like to be an actor, an actress? I said, no. Would you like to be an actor? I said, no. Would you like to be a broadcaster? I said, broadcaster, no. I said, okay, would you like to be a teacher? I said, yes, I love to teach. He said, okay. That means it's something you can do. So someone who likes to talk can be a teacher. So I said, but how can I be a teacher now? I've studied business administration. She said, you can go back to do your PhD or even do your master's in education. said, well, I think I can do that. So I went to National Teachers Institute to study PGD education. And I went to National Open University to do Masters in Educational Admin and Planning. Still thinking I was going to go back to the classroom. But I decided to just be trainer of adults. I did, fortunately, I did information marketing with my mentor, Dr. Sonia Obazo-Ejiagbese, years back. So when I, with my knowledge of teaching now, I just combined it with information marketing. I picked a niche in business. So, and I actually still streamlined it to internet business. That's why I got the name Queen of Internet Business, because I was basically studying various internet businesses people could do, and I would bring it to limelight. I would do seminars on it. I would go on radio. I would talk about it, that you can do this business online, you can do that. So that was what I started doing, and that's what I still do to today. Even though now we are trying to expand our business, I'm trying to bring in other trainers. I'm expanding my training business, basically bringing in now other trainers to know that you can use the internet to still teach. So basically I'm still doing the same thing, but now I'm living a life of fulfillment. Over the past 9 years, I've done training, I've written books, I've done my YouTube video, I've used every avenue I have to affect lives. And for my physical training, well over 100,000 persons have attended. And sometimes when I wake up in the morning, someone will just call and say, love, my wife wants to pray for you. And just because I show them that online business and the person is doing it, the person is able to feed his family. So there's this fulfillment I get now. I remember one time, of course I also make mistakes because I'm a human. I remember one time I was the third of 18 million and my client's menu was involved, and I got threats, different kind of threats. You are a scam, you are this, which was even when it was a police case. Unfortunately, we caught one of the scammers who convinced that I didn't know anything about it. But then we still had this threat that was coming. So one day I said to one of them, look, my conscience is clear. And even if you decide to kill me today, I'll be living as a fulfilled person because I know how many lives I have impacted. That's to tell you that I'm happy that I'm doing what I'm doing now. I'm living a fulfilled life. That's the same thing I want for you. Living a life of purpose and impact. If you can discover your talent, because now I have discovered my talent for training. So I love to train. It gives me joy. That's the only thing I can do for free. Once you discover your talent, see how you can develop a business around it. Remember when I discovered my talent? I didn't discover that I love to teach. I didn't know I was supposed to be teaching. I discovered that I have talent for talking. So it means that God can give each and every one of us talent. Like my younger brother, his talent was drawing. That my father beat that out of him. So I thank God my father didn't beat out talking for me, because perhaps I would have been an introvert by now. Because that's not who I am. I'm born to talk. And I'm using this opportunity now to talk. By doing my YouTube, by doing my various training, all I do is talking. But as someone who loves to talk, you may be a comedian, you may be a broadcaster, or an actor. So you choose what exactly you want to use your talent to do. What business can you bring out of your talent? That talent that God has given to you, you can bring out a business around it, and you can expand the business. Today, I'm expanding my business, a training business, but I want other trainers to come on our platform to train. And we are giving opportunity to more people to be able to train on our platform. It all started from me discovering my talent and developing it. All I did was to develop my talent. So when you discover your talent, you need to take time to develop it. So you will need to learn some skills that will help you to harness or to grow that talent. You need to learn. If you need to go meet, for instance, if your talent is talking and you felt, oh, I could do comedy, if you need to go and sit down under a comedian, an established comedian, and learn from that person, then do so. If you have to go to school to go and become a broadcaster, I had to go to school. I had to go and do PhD in education and do masters. As I'm talking to you now, my lecturer there wanted me to go do PhD in education. But I don't feel I want to do PhD at this time. Maybe sometime later I could do PhD, because I'm not someone that likes writing exams. Well, I didn't have a choice. I had to write it all those years. So now PhD, even though I'm told there's no exam, all you need to do is to write a paper and all that out to this. I just don't feel like doing it right now. So maybe sometime soon I would go and do my PhD. But for now, I'm just doing my training people. And right now I'm trying to grow my training business, getting other trainers involved soon. We're having our channel, a new YouTube channel, and I'll be telling you about it. We're going to be talking about the new training business and how you can be part of it. You can be part of it as you're listening to us, because we have different aspects. The other aspect is for training of entrepreneurs. So it's called the business school, 10,000 Naira business school. So I'm working on that project called 10,000 Naira business school, and it will be launched in the next 1 month. We'll be launching it. So don't worry, stay tuned. I will be telling you when we are launching our YouTube channel, that will be taking care of the business, and there will be a lot of gifts the first day we are going to launch that YouTube channel, so you don't want to miss out at all. So why am I doing all this? It was because I discovered my talent for training, and now I started training business. If you discover your talent for training or teaching, and after going for my PhD in education, master's education, I could decide I want to be a teacher in a school, which is fine, which is great as well. But I didn't go back to do teaching in an educational institution, but I am still teaching. So various ways that you can use your talent to serve life. When you discover your talent and you're using it to serve life, you will discover that you're living a life of purpose and impact. And that's what I want for you. I want you to be living a life of purpose and impact. I want you to be living a fulfilled life. Because if you're fulfilled, you'll be happy. And you're going to infect other lives with your happiness. I want a world that is filled with happiness, where we are all happy doing what we are doing. So thank you for watching today's video. I hope you've learned. I hope you go back within and ask yourself, am I living a life of purpose and impact? Who am I impacting? So that's what you should be asking yourself. Who are you impacting? So remember, we'll be launching a new channel soon. It may even be within this month, and there will be loads of gifts on that channel. So just stay tuned with me. In my next video, I'll be telling you the name of the channel, and all you need to do is to go subscribe, and probably you'll be one of the winners of the gift. Please, if you're not subscribed on this channel, please do so right now. And remember to click on the notification button, so that when next I post my video, we do this every Thursday. I have new videos up every Thursday. Don't worry, I'm going to break again. The kids are already 1 month old, so they can... And a lot of people taking care of them, so I can now concentrate on, you know, doing my videos and every other thing. So don't worry, no more break. Oh, I promise you, no more break. So every Thursday you'll be able to watch new videos from me, and you can meet on my blog loveoladele.net, on my Instagram loveoladele official. Thank you. See ya.